All right, we're ready to start. Get to rant about my stupidly large map. It's pretty divisive between the players who have played the entire episode too. This starts with quite a big hop. You have like different directions where you have to go for the progression. The entire goal is to open this big door. You need 3 keys for it. All of these pillars you have to push down. And thinking about like where should I go first, what should I show. Try to get as many secrets as possible if I remember all of them, that's fine. Probably be around 2 hours or something. Obscure secret that you have to use some ramp jumping to get the buttons. Not many people find this. Then we find my little mechanic, or whatever you would call this device, can be used to do some crazy stuff. I think I like this better. The episode 2 one. After all, I made the first map in. Episode 1 map in like 1 month. This one was more effort. Hard to hit the grenades. All of these areas that I'm doing right now are just optional. Where did they come from? Just idle without the sounds. So, this whole area that I'm exploring right now, there are these orb buttons that you have to find in the level to open these doors, and you get some resources as a reward. We found one of them earlier on the top area that we were exploring, so I managed to take one door. Here's the second one. So this room is dedicated for the orb buttons that are spread across the map. And when you press these buttons, it will tell you where the button is located in. And this one is missing because we already found it, so it's done. The same with this. Yes, and that's an interesting one, where you have to fail jumping puzzles 15 times. I'll get to that when we reach that part of the level. First we have some clearing to do here. And this is the final door that you can open when you get all the orbs. This quad is really handy. Shells here that I can pick up with all your lost ammo pack. Yeah, the brute kick is really brutal. It knocks you back and does tons of damage. Really dangerous to get close. There's our crystal lens over there. We need 4 orbs for that. Oh. It's a nice ambush. Yeah, water portals like vertical water walls that you can swim up are really nice design. I hope that more people use them in their maps. There's this squad still, but I'm not sure where I would use it. I didn't plan any routing when I started playing, so... start with the more simple stuff. I'll do this wing first. There's a button for a secret. Many connected secret areas here. You can get the mega health here. You can climb up these slanted ramps. Just keep holding forward. One more thing, you can jump on top of this blocks, lights. This is where you get the earliest rotary shotgun of the level. There's one of the silver keys. Well, this area that we're going to go through, it loops all the way back there, so we can get the key. There's one more thing on the water that we didn't explore yet, right over here. Is this respawning? No, it wasn't. There's one of these wind tunnels that you can use to jump around.
Kippy _ is now following.
Thanks for the following, Kippy. And I was thinking about this pentagram as well. There's quad damage in pentagram. You can kind of do some crazy stuff with both of these if you want to combine them, but it's up to the players how they want to play. There's one more little secret that we can get by using the jumper, if I do it right. It's a tail cell area. There's a lot of tails. inside of the cells. Oh. Yeah, there's the text. Forgot about that kamikaze right behind the corn. Yeah, we have full cells, so we don't really get anything out of this area. Except for sniping, if I want to snipe. If I had targets here, I could spend my cells. Now we can get back to the normal progression again. Yeah, this room actually that we were exploring before. This was the first thing that I made for 12 episode 2. All the way back in like, was it like 2021 summer? So almost 2 years ago. If you touch these runes, you will trigger the nail trap. Yeah, it's been a long time, hasn't it? It's really fun to snipe these ogres with one rail hit. You can move this wall back to its normal position and get access to this teleporter. Because I started with the previous items that I had. There's no lack of ammo in this level. You find enough secrets, you can just overstack on everything. Oh boy, this area. Hit it. There we go. Yeah, this is one of those really explore heavy areas as well. Buttons. Might as well get the mega health right now. Kinda weird that Scrag doesn't see you when you move around. Monsters. Pretty low on armor again, but this map thankfully has a lot of armor pickups, so you can really afford to make a lot of mistakes, even though the monster count is really high. Next. Let's go for the secrets first. I see the surprise spawn. This is really handy pentagram to use here. Huh. pretty safe when you have the invulnerability. Behind that waterfall. I'll grab the old key now. Use this ring for it. Okay, there's one more big secret on this area that I have to explore. Yeah, this door is time button operated, so need to get to the button and run really fast. Might as well take this armor because I'm not gonna come back here. There's one secret over here. It's easily missable if you fall. Oh my god. Okay. That was absolutely terrible. Maybe I'll get it better this time. Focusing a little bit so I can clear this without any accidents. Okay, that's fine. I don't need to get all the kills. Just one of the buttons. Thank you. that leads back all the way here. That whole area just optional for that orb button. Here comes the fun part. This is probably the most involved thing I've ever done in Quake mapping, so it's gonna be something. Yep, that brute was brutalizing me. To be really careful here. Just keeps on going. It's not over yet. Well, thankfully you can just stand here and wait. Watch the fireworks. Hi, Deepop. Yeah, just in time for Tetris. Here it comes. That's about it. There's one more surprise before we get the silver key from this area. That wasn't enough. Here we go. Just a couple of spawns. Because everyone loves spawns. Secret above the Tetris area. Huh. 24 secrets found already. That's quite a few. Did I even say the map name at the start? I kind of forgot. Yeah, the map is called Abyss of the Troglodytes. B2M8, just before the boss fight of the episode. No, I'm not going to use the keys yet. I'm going to save them. Let's do this part first. I mean, next. See the secret area that we were in earlier, above this area. Secrets, because why not? I could have just dropped down from the other side. Well, whatever. Here's an interesting part where you get a ring and you can use it really well to your advantage if you know what you're doing. So I'll show what you should do with this power. There's quite a few shamblers here, so if you look up you can see those spikes. Use the railgun here to get both of those guys. Not gonna go down there yet, but I think I killed all the shamblers. How do I concept my secrets? I just add them when I feel like it. Like if I'm making the map and I get some cool idea, I'll just add the secret right there and then. Usually I don't add secret stuff at the end of the process, no. Unless it's like some kind of reference or something like that. That I need to include somewhere. It's so dark. The sun is shining on my monitor right now, so it's hard to see anything. still clear enough to see. Snipe off the enemies. Okay, there's a couple more secrets on this area that I'm gonna get. Yeah, the orb thing, it was just the idea that I had for the map to include. Just kept adding them in different locations and adding the resources room to the map. I can't remember when I built it, but it was in the process of making the map, not after the fact. That's how you take good care of those floors. The same with these ogres. Alright, that's all the secrets on this area at least. Now we can go swimming again. The great thing that was added on copper is that boars underwater, they don't like pose much of a threat because the projectile arc is quite wide underwater. Makes them really easy to deal with. These three buttons that I shot, they opened this door here. With some resources. Oh yeah, forgot the button. Go. Hi, Sputnik. Did you finish 12-2 already? Yourself. One more. guess you did because you said it's 5-star map. So much damage from the jump. To grab another breathing aid. Oh damn. 3.5 hours. That's nuts. Oh, exploring really takes that much time when you do it first time. You can use the railgun underwater, so you don't have to worry about discharging. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Hopefully we can make the episode 3 as good as the second one. Another nested secret for another orb button. 6 out of 12. Now we get some really spicy arena fights. This is a really, really fun fight, even though it's just a square room, but you get to fight almost every monster in the game. Yeah, there's so many ogres and brutes that are just raining grenades on you, so you have to keep moving and mind your steps. you look around, you can kind of see that this room looks almost like it's upside down as well. That's the whole gimmick of this area. Go through this portal. And if you pay attention to this wall skulls that are here, you can see how it like warps around. It's pretty cool. But first we have some jumping to do. This might take a while because there's really hard jumps to make. You can go climbing really far. Hi, Corina. Right time to see my epic gameplay on my own map. I already died once. Underwater part. Accidentally shot two spawns too close to me.
Marky music is now following.
Marky music. Finally, you decided to follow me after all these years. Well, I should be knowing this map. I would be worried if I didn't know. Oh yeah, I can get there even. I have to do the other part first. Hi, Pekka. What's up in the Doom community side of things? We should be about halfway through the monster count. Yeah, just about. Clearing this room is kind of fun. I'm gonna try and get this power up for it. It's really helpful. You can do the same type of jumping on this side. That doesn't count, I was reading chat. That's cool. Yeah, Doom community is so wild, they just keep on making stuff. They never stop. I guess in Quake side of things, we just have a couple of episodes coming up that people are waiting for. Hopefully being released soon rather than later. Alright, I need to focus on this part now. It's gonna be a mess. All the dangerous threats are now over. Hmm. Yeah, the railgun is so good. Well, the crystal lancer, actually. That's what it's called. Now there are some buttons that I need to shoot. For you to pick up. I love it. That's a good question. Why doesn't the coffin burn in lava? Okay, now we can go all the way back to the other side. We have to do this jump again. Good doing. Yeah, and the jumping physics and movement, how you can like change your direction in the air. There's a lot of options to make maps for Quake. The only thing that bothered me when I started making Quake maps is that the movement speed is capped. In like Quake 3 or other Quake games, you can actually accelerate faster. Well, there's a mechanic called power bunny hopping that you can get past that, but it's really hard to perform and it's kind of annoying. I just ignore that completely. Now we're on the other side, where the lava is in the ceiling. That's my epic joke. Now there's one more thing that we can do, because that door opened. On the other secret, there's now a corresponding door that has opened. This jump is kind of scary. There we go. I did the big moving wall puzzle first. I saved the real puzzle part for the last. We're going there next after I'm done with this part.
Yeah.
this is pretty scary part when you don't have the scuba gear. Keep taking air. There's a secret over here. Which gives you the scoop here. Makes this section much easier to deal with. On easier difficulties, there are actually like more scuba gears on the normal path. You don't have to find the secret, but on hard difficulty, you have to find on the secret. Same with all the puzzles and stuff on this level. If you play it on hard, they are really hard puzzles. But if you play on easier difficulties, there's like aids that help you to get through. Like platforms that don't exist in hard difficulty are there for easier difficulties. So you don't have to be any kind of jumping master if you play on easy difficulty. Okay, that's the second silver key that we have now. This time you can get the rail stuff here. There's some more stuff that have opened in this underwater temple area. I might as well just grab everything. I don't mind thinking about where I would use them. Yeah, that's it. Now that we have the scuba gear, we can actually clear this area. Yeah. It's pretty easy for me when I made the secrets. I can find them so easy. One more. This is one of those completely optional areas in the level. Couple more secrets here. The early probably lightning gun here if you decide to go here first. I get another berserk power up. To swing the axe. Is damage in Quake RNG or reliable? It's more reliable than in Doom. There are a few factors that change some damage values, but in Quake it's pretty consistent. Yeah, what the worker says, but almost everything else is consistent. One more secret that I want to get from this side before I go deeper. Here we can perform some cool ramp jumps. If I can get it. There we go. Since this is like a secret area, I figured like if you play on easy difficulty, you have probably enough health to just rocket jump up here and get it like that. Or you can just practice this jump and make it after practicing for like maybe a few days. I don't know. This opens a door on the other side of this wall that we can't get to yet, but we will make our way there shortly. I don't forgot the order. Huh. Yeah, you have to press those buttons in the right order to be able to make it in time. And those platforms extend to the middle. So now we can get the other secret. I'm making our way here. Anyone know what this reference is? Other than people who who already know from my commentary. I used to play a lot of Diablo 2. Hidden button behind the room. There are no cows here. Oh, it changes every time. Just when you get bored with one of the classes, then you play another one. But of course everyone plays sorcerers, so yeah, there's always that. Oh yeah, the Act 2 boss, that's really crazy. Just hammers you down, physical attacks. Well, dying doesn't mean much if you play on softcore. You don't have to do the one death run for the entire game. Okay, so if you fail this jump and you fall down, I'm letting you know that you can always try again. Now from the earlier, when we had the puzzle information room, there was a clue that you have to fail jumping puzzle for 15 times. This is the thing, these puzzles on this area, if you fall down, it increases the counter. You have to fall down 15 times to open the door where you get the orb. But every time you fall, there's more monsters that you have to fight. Look up. That's where we have to go. It looks pretty intimidating. Sneaky knight over there. Huh. think I'll do the failing part after finishing all the puzzles, so I'm gonna do this path in the normal way. Yeah, if we get the clears, then I'll make the power level in 12-3. Nailed it, literally. Oh, or maybe not. That nice mid-air grenade from the ogre on the side. Yeah, this is on hard difficulty, so this is the hardest variation of that. But if you fail enough of times, then you will get shortcuts that skip the puzzles, so you don't have to do them all over again. Hit me. Now we have a shortcut, we can skip the first race. Don't have to do this anymore. It's quite a puzzle that you have to do. On hard difficulty, these are scrambled, so every button has multiple platforms that it moves, but on easier difficulties, you just have to press them all in a series, right in same order every time. There's no thinking required. Now we just need to get that one. Huh. Oh wait, I forgot one. Yeah, that corner. Now we have it.
Sand Peterson is now following.
Thanks for the follow, Sand Peterson. It takes all your armor if you fail that. As badly as I did. Thanks for fishing me, lots of fun. Had a lot of fun making this map. Hi, Alopecia. We're hopefully doing the last part of my, well, playthrough. This is a map that I made for episode 2. It's the second last map before the boss. So yeah, this is another cool little puzzle that you have to figure out how to align these pillars. But if you're good at jumping, you don't have to align them all of them. You can skip some of jumps. Like this. Yeah, you can fully solve it if you pay attention how the buttons operate the platforms, I mean the pillars. doors down there. It's really cool how people have picked up well and started playing it. I saw that Duke TV guy started playing on episode 2. I tried to watch some of the VODs. It's too bad that I can't catch those streams live because of time zones. And I usually go to bed before 3 a.m. so... I'm glad that people enjoy. Okay, now we're up to the next puzzle. This is your typical Indiana Jones bullshit. You can quite clearly tell what's wrong here. And no, you can't jump over them. If you jump, they still trigger. They don't trigger from monsters. No, that's something at least. There's a cool secret behind the rushing walls. Whatever. They can stay alone. Get another lightning gun. And a spot where you can kill the ogres easily. How many secrets? There's 60 secrets total. So far we have 51. You can see that these platforms have something special under them, except few of them. So if you pay attention, you think about where you have to jump and find the right pattern. Just to make sure. This one. Okay. Wait, did I remember it right? Nice short-term memory. Oh, let's try. Well, unfortunately, the fiend dropped down, but that's not a big problem. Small secret. Going over the platforms. This is where the railgun comes really handy. Can do that without taking any damage. This is a scary room. Easy peasy. And now we have all the silver keys. Still the quad. And the puzzles I need to fail. Let's get to that part. It's gonna be just jumping down for a bit. All of them, all the drops. We still have the power up over here that we didn't take. Let's go with this. Well, we don't have any more monsters to kill. At least on this run. Let's check the other route. This doesn't open yet. Okay. Few more times we have to fall. Absolutely have to do this if you want to go for 100% kills and secrets. Nah, that was fine. Just thought about making a cool little reward for players who can't make the jumps. Make it feel like the part of progress in some way. There we have it. 11 out of 12. Yeah, there are some monsters behind the shortcuts as well, but I'm not gonna bother with those. It's gonna take too much time to clear everything. That's one of the stupid references that I keep on my head forever.
Colossus underscore Ops is now following.
Hi Colossus. Are you able to use the chat now? Or do I have to tweak more? Hi, there you are. And finally chat. Now there's one more orb that I have to find, and it's over here, behind that moving wall that we had earlier, way back then. Yeah, I wonder who made this shit. He must have been a pretty crazy person to do this. Unfortunately, we have to climb back up from this area now. Nothing happened there. Even if I didn't use the noclip, I would have been fine. Now you can go and collect all the rewards from the doors. I'm gonna go here first. Yeah, might as well use this. Some fun jumping in. What next? Oh yeah, under here. All of these I took, or so it's just the one last room here that remains. Now we are fully stacked. There's nothing stopping us. I'll take the power-ups as well, so we get to have some fun. Yeah, I need to do the jumps first. That's really fun to do that way. You get to rail those shamblers in a row like that. Looks so funny. Oh, you can't follow me? That's weird. That's pretty much it. Just missed 5 kills somewhere. I don't even remember where they are. There's one. 51. That's fine. All the secrets and stuff. Now it's time for the boss fight. Only 1 hour and 45 minutes, not too bad. Considering I was constantly explaining stuff while playing. Oh yeah, the kill counter is bugged because I'm using Quake's passion. It doesn't show the 4-digit four digits in the intermission screen. Thanks for the GG. I really can't pronounce that word. But the map title is on the bottom, so you can see that. This is the boss fight level for, well, episode 2. Yes, it's time to end this. Apero Hedron. Okay. I think I got it pretty close. Let's see if I can do this in the first try. Last time I played this, I was able to beat it. It's pretty hard to explain what's going on here, but it's a bullet hell. Oh, nice spawn. You can check where you can move based on these red circles. They show where it's going to attack. It's a nice little telegraph that we added here. Yeah, the map screenshotter. Now to the scary part. Think I made it. Yep. No explosions. And here's the final lore bit for episode 2. I'll take this moment to take a short break. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. No catch, unfortunately. Yeah, the music was amazing on this episode. Alex did a really nice job. There it is, two relics that we have placed on this machine. Just have to find out later what it does when it's fully charged. I think we should do the credits room at the end of the episode too. There are still three bonus maps that I can play. I'll let Fairweather to answer that question. Yeah, that's about right. So yeah, here's all the people involved in making this mod for Quake. It's quite a big team. Eighteen people. Listed here. Dracon for his world-renowned wall trim stuff. Pinchy. Bed associate. JCR Coconut. It's his dog again. On the picture. Henry, British. As given, yeah. Cool boy. Apex Twin fan. Dance, literally a doctor. Dance made some models, right? Or for 12, right? I don't recall like exactly what models, but there's some models there still left in 12, right? Runes, maybe? And here's Marky, Michael. Or Mike Heal, I guess. Totally his face. BMFBR, best of the pizza. And here's Alex, as we were talking about music. He made all the music on, well, except for one track that Marky made, I think. VTuber correspondent. Here's your boy, Fairweather. Procrastinator. But in the end, with all the procrastination, we actually finished it well, so it's nice. The episode 2 at least. Yeah. Professional. Would be pretty nice to get paid for procrastinating. And then we have Baal, of course. Scope expansion team. Baal did an amazing job with all the models and assets that we used in the levels. And making the visual pass for Marquis map. It's amazing. The second map, third map on episode 2. Oh yeah, and the boss that we just beat. That was all Baal's handiwork, the model. Yeah, hopefully by then we have we have 12 finished. Yeah, this is me, employee number 37. Void Force, Mad Code Maniac. Void Force did all the tricky programming that no one else was able to finish. That took like ages, months even. I would say that Void Force was really the most deciding factor at releasing 12-2 in time. Without him, we would still be wondering how the hell we program stuff. Pretty sure. And here's Lunaran, Idiot Wangler Extraordinaire. We can thank Popper Mod for helping 12 be what it is, and Lunar made the copper, so it's a very appropriate credit to give. Yes, Justly, Chief Romit's officer, mapping stuff. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention all the contributions, but yeah, I guess it's pretty obvious when you read the text files. The time. Pedant in chief. Well, I don't remember like every contribution what people made, but yeah, it's in the text files. Chambler Note, Ratman, and Greenwood resident Florida man. And that's pretty much the credits. Now there's still the bonus maps left. I'm thinking if I should do them now or take a break, but I'm not sure. Well, it's been only 2 hours. I think I can easily play the bonus maps. So I'll get to that right away. Here is the first bonus map, Weeping Shades by Weeping Shades of Indigo by Henry. All of these bonus maps are deathmatch maps that we made for Dwell, and hopefully we'll get the proper procs and implementations for multiplayer, so we can have the railgun battles and all that good stuff in deathmatch. Yeah, let's go with this. Yeah, I have 4 maps in Dwell now, so if you count all of those maps up, it's like half of the playtime. Pretty nuts to think about. Yeah, there's only 87 monsters and 6 secrets in this map. It's fairly short. And we get to experience the weapon progression again. We didn't carry any with us. Wow, he didn't get stunned. That's amazing. That can happen. Fiends are so dangerous when they just start leaping everywhere. Only we did try playing 12. Yeah, no one else has given it a shot yet. So dead. Yeah, the netquake works, but there needs to be like systems built in, like map changing and voting and stuff. But I think we had some problem with the respawning ammo. I'm not sure. We have to check up on that later. Mm. I can use this now. Yeah, exactly, Colossus. Everyone's just playing E1, M2 forever. Nothing else. Any auto saves on this? What is your reasoning? Why should they play only old maps? Worker. That's not fun. You already know the maps. Don't you want to learn something new in life? But that's the great thing. Not even other people don't know the maps, so you can be the first who know how to play them. Nice. Thanks for stopping by, Alopecia. Give you a shout out before you go. Oh, I'm so dead. That's all. There's one more monster somewhere in the five secrets. I don't remember them. But do you want to be efficient or do you want to be creative? That's the thing. Yeah, let's go pick up the second deathmatch map. Well, if you want, we can always go duel in Skull if you want. The best map ever made. It's pretty good constitution for new maps. But yeah, anyways, this is deck 37 PC by me. 12DM3 is the number. Catch you later, worker. Oh, we were playing Streets of Rage 2 last time. It's kinda cool. That was badly timed. Almost done with Dwell. After this, there's only one more bonus map left to play. These maps are really fast-paced, so I can just go and run and gun. Nothing much to say about this except that it's based on a pretty popular layout from a different game franchise other than Quake. Deck 17 or 16, which game you prefer really. Thank you. But yeah, rip, pick. An Unreal. It's a shame what they did with the games. Here we can get the secret dragon. Yeah, of course. That's what they use this for. I don't think anyone is going to play Unreal Tournament 3. Oh yeah. Forgot about this card. I don't think the curse had anything to do with it. Yeah, 4 was great for what it was. Chance ruined my rail shot. I'm gonna save those power-ups anyways. This is where things get really fun on this level. Get to have a huge arena battle with a lot of monsters. Let's get those rockets first. The nails. Secret, get some more power-ups, just why not? Left and spend them. Just playing insta-gip with monsters in Quake 1. Pretty one-sided though. forgot this power up here. Would have been fun to use that. There's only two monsters left. Oh, there they are. That's 100%. Nice. 16 minutes. Damn. Triple shot railguns, sure. Well, you only have one more map left to play. There's some interesting mechanic on it where you... Oh, okay. Never mind about that. Yeah, there's an interesting time limit mechanic on this map. Where if you beat the map in 10 minutes, you get extra secret. That's like a super secret, basically. Yeah, this is called Perfect Annihilus, and it's a reference again to the game that we were talking about before. This is DM7 or 12. There he goes. If you get into the skybox on this level, you die. So it's not a good idea to jump up there. Really early super nailgun seeker. Clean all the enforcers through the windows. I have to go there. Jump. Yeah, the haste makes the axe look really weird. Teamwork. Access to this jumper, we can go back up. Couple of secrets that we can get. Mr. Chandler. I'll just activate everything. The map. Too fast. Thank you. Well, because of the axe. Yeah, Daigatana is something else. It's such a weird game. I do it from Doom. How's your day been? I'm almost done with 12. This is the last map that we're gonna play. So you're gonna play it as well? Are you gonna stream it? Oh damn. That's all of the normal progress, you know. Yeah, I mean, any way you like to do them, it's fine. 80 is pretty cool as well. That's such a nice design on levels. Extra mission here. Here, I need to get. One more on the other side that I missed. It in time. I wonder what my time was. We'll see that now. 13 minutes and 49 seconds, yeah. Needed to play slightly faster for that better Annihilus charm. Yeah, that's 12. Now we've done all the content that there's currently in 12. Episode 1, episode 2, and all 3 bonus maps. Looking forward for these two things here. Thanks for the GGs. And hope you have fun with it as well when you get to play. I'm trying to think if I have anything else that I should add at the end, but I'm not sure. Yeah, I wanna make more maps when we get to it. I want to try and make a shorter level. I don't want to make a penultimate level again. Like on episode 1 and 2, I had the second last map for them. I started to get a little bit crazy with the design. So yeah, definitely. Want to do something a little bit smaller. Thanks for dropping by, Sputnik. Have a good night. Hi, zombie. Coming in clutch at the right at the end of the stream. This is a good track to put at the end.